Hello friends, this lecture is in continuation with your previous lecture series of CNC machines and automation. We have started the unit number 2 and I hope you have studied well about the previous lectures. Today we are going to discuss the two major issues of CNC machine, which is the holding devices for tool and holding devices for jobs. There are variety of things are available for the CNC machine, but today we are going to discuss very specified area of these tools and jobs, holding devices for tools and jobs. So starting with the tools, so you might have seen in this image that you might have seen on the simple or conventional machines, whether it is a lathe machine, milling machine, you have seen these kind of holding devices. But why we are using for that? There are four major reasons that we are using these special kind of holding devices. First of all is the rigidity. Rigidity means whatever the forces should be applied on, whatever the balancing should be, unbalanced forces are applied, this should remain rigid. It should not displace from its location. Second is quick changing. This is a feature of the holding device, that if you wanted to change as per the job, you wanted to change the holding devices quickly in no time or a fraction of time. Then the third is security and setup. Security of machine as well as the security of the worker. And setup, both should be the security would be high, but the setup time would be less. That is the important feature. Next is adequate access of cutting tool to the part. It means your holding device should not be blocking the path of tool while working on the job, because it is seen that to make the job rigid, to make the job easy to set up, making all the features, sometimes we miss that it. Access of the tool to the job is very limited because of this holding device. So we wanted to design that kind of device which is having adequate access, maximum access to the job while working on the machine. So the holding devices for the tool, there are two types. Holding devices of tool, there are two types, the spindle tooling and as well as the flexible tooling. So if I would start with the spindle tooling, which is directly installed onto the spindle. It is a ready-made tool which is directly installed onto the spindle, that is called spindle tooling. So it is used for to perform milling, drilling, boring and tapping function. So what kind of holding devices do we have? These are the holding devices. The first one is collet chuck. The collet chuck you might have seen in the simple lathe machines even, but in the CNC machine it is very common. So this is the collet chuck. Collet chuck is defined for each diameter. You can't use for the various diameter, it is defined for limited diameters. Next is end mill adapter. The similar kind of thing, end mill operator. Similar kind of thing that we are having the chuck, you can't use the for a limited size, for a limited diameter, you are using the end mill operator. Then the face mill. This is for the face mill adapter. So every tool has an adapter. Means you just fix the adapter, fit it into it, the tool, and you will start working on it. This is one is a screw end mill holder. This is a screw end mill holder. Then tapping head and boring head, we all know that is tapping is for to create the threads, boring is to enlarge the diameter of the hole. Last is shell mill adapter. So these are the different kind of adapters which are directly installed into the spindle and in which you can hold your tool. So that's why it is called tool holding devices. Then the second type is flexible tooling. This is the the future of the CNC machine, the flexible tooling. Flexible tooling stands for you can adjust any type of tool on this machine. Any type of tool. So there are two parts. The first part is called machine dependent part or called as a backend. And second one is the cutting tool dependent part, which is called adapter. If you just see this image, this is your adapter in which your tool is holded. This is your tool, ceramic tool, it is holded in here, and this one is your this is the back end which is connected to the machine. Fine. So it is flexible tooling is of two types. It means it is divided in two types. One is back end which is connected to the machine, and second is your adapter in which tool is holded. So this part is extra than your spindle tooling. Why this is given? Because you can hold any type of tool inside this holder. But there's one condition for that is it is used for usually lightweight tool heads. Means for the heavy heads, if your tool is so heavy, you cannot install into the flexible tooling. The first condition is this. The second is same head can be used for the external and internal machine. That is the advantage. The same head which is used here, this one, this head can be used for internal as well as for the external machine. Then the next is advantage, it is more versatile, means many number of type of tools can be used, and the reduced cost. It is also reducing the cost, it is very less costly. Then the work holding devices. It is a tool holding devices, now the work holding devices. The work holding devices characteristics, firstly, as we have seen the characteristics for the tool, now we have to see the characteristics for the work holding devices. It should allow to perform number of operations, that is the first requirement. If you have the less number of operations, the holding device would not be perfect. Chip removal would be easy, so that your chip cannot stuck inside the holding device. You can easily clean it out, wipe it out. No interference to the cutting tool. It is important. Why? Because if the interference would be there, you need to adjust your program. Clear? So that is a time consuming step. Next is avoid incorrect loading and clamping. So that is in the CNC machine, we have sensors to check this out. So avoid incorrect loading. Then the strong and rigid, we all know that quick loading and unloading, very fine. Then simple and safe to operate. Yeah, it should be simple. Your holding means tightening just one screw, your work should be holded up. Otherwise, if you are having multiple things to control, that is not the perfect one. Then the component should not move after loading. Yes, it should be so rigid that your component should not be moving. Your job should not be moving here and there. Fine. Then this is a two types of job holding devices. You can see in this. This is a CNC machine, and this is your holding device. This is your workpiece, and this one is your holding device. It is used to hold this workpiece, and this is your tool which is coming out from here. So there are two types: the job holding devices, the linear pallet and the rotary pallet. So what is the linear pallet system? Linear pallet shuttle system. It means your job is coming to one, and then it is shifted to the second, then it is shifted to the third, then it is shifted to the fourth one. It means your workpiece is moving in a linear system, that is becoming your linear pallet shuttle system. Your job is holded over here, and when it moves into the machine, this would remain vacant. Seeing here, this would remain vacant, and when it comes out, so it would be moved here and so on in the further movement. So it's a linear pallet system. Your job is holded in linear. Then the rotary pallet system. When your job is holded in a rotary table. Job is holded on a rotary table. You can see in here. These are the rotary tables, and different machines are working on the periphery outside of the outer periphery of the this circle on which your job is fixed. So this is called a rotary pallet system. So these are the two holding devices. Whether you hold the job in a linear pallet system, or you can hold the job in rotary pallet system. Fine. So this is all about today. And if you wanted to check my previous video, you must go into this link. And for the further videos also, you must subscribe this channel. So, thank you and take care.